Hello dear students, good morning. How are you doing? Fine. Okay. In the last class we have seen the traffic control devices article, in which signs, one of the traffic control device which you have learned. There are three types of signs: regulatory signs or mandatory signs, you can see here, and you have already learned. Second one, warning or cautionary signs. Third one being informatory signs. All these signs are more useful for road users. To the road users, it will be more useful. Now we will go for the second type of traffic control device, that is traffic signals. Everybody aware this type of signals is commonly or generally being used: red for stop, green for go signal, amber, that is the time for clearance or clearance time. So whenever you are approaching an intersection, you cannot bring the vehicle into halt position suddenly. That is the reason why amber light, as soon as you see, you can retard your speed and come to a dead stop till you get the proceed signal, that is green signal or go signal. Even as soon as green signal comes, it is not possible. That's why before green signal, again amber signal will be light on, so that you can start your vehicle if at all you are put off, and you can accelerate and slowly you can take your vehicle ahead. So what are signals? Traffic signals are nothing but the control devices which could alternately direct the traffic to stop and proceed at intersections using red and green traffic light signals, which I have already mentioned along with the figure, automatically. Sometimes we can go non-automatic light signals also. It can be operated by policemen at the intersections. Nowadays everywhere we are going for automatic signals. Types of traffic signals. What are the types of traffic signals? Traffic control signals and pedestrian signals. This is traffic control signals. This is pedestrian signal. You can see here, pedestrian signal, red light when comes, along with the figure of or image of the human being, you have to stop. You should not cross, even though there is zebra crossing, because vehicles are crossing that zebra crossing. As soon as you get the green light with the image of the human being, means pedestrians are allowed to move on the zebra crossing safely and confidently without any problem. Now, traffic control signals, they have three color light glows. These are known as glows. These color light glows facing each direction of traffic flow. Red light means stop, green means to go, yellow or amber means allows the clearance time, as I said. Pedestrian signals, they are meant to give the right of way to pedestrian to cross a road during the walk period. So when the green light comes, it gives some period for walk on the zebra crossing. That is known as walk period. When the vehicular traffic shall be stopped by red or stop signal on the traffic signals of the road, then passenger, that is pedestrian, can easily cross the road. Advantages of signals and disadvantages of signals. First we will see advantages. Signal is provided at intersection to manage the traffic flow. Signals also provide safety to the vehicular traffic and pedestrians. They reduce and avoid the accidents. Signals are easy to understand compared to traffic police management at intersection. It is better than manual signal. Disadvantages of signals. Fast moving vehicles may cause a rear end collision at signalized intersection. Improper design of signal cycle length can cause fixed delay, because when once the red signal phase is fixed, say 32 seconds, means even though there are no vehicles in the perpendicular leg of road, you are required to stop till you get the green signal. That's why survey data is made use of while designing the signal properly, so that such problems of fixed delay could be avoided. In that way only it is designed. If at all it is not designed properly, then such fixed delay will cause. Duration of peak hour unnecessary delay occur at signalized intersection. It is also. Until unless from the field data, actual or factual data is not collected properly, the off-peak hour time, we have to increase the phase of the green signal, rather red signal. In that case, delay can be avoided. Traffic island. A small raised area, you can see here, small raised area in the middle of the road, which provides a safe place for pedestrians to stand. Suppose if number of vehicles are moving on either side, you may not be able to go on any sides, so that you can stand on this parking area, that is island, till vehicle moves, and then you can start crossing the road from this island. Pedestrian to stand and marks a division between two opposing stream of traffic. One traffic direction will be left to right and right to left, opposite direction movements. Or it is also called as an island is solid or painted object in a road that channelizes the traffic. It can also be a narrow strip of island between roads that intersect at an acute angle. There are mainly four types: divisional islands, channelizing islands or channeling islands, pedestrian loading islands, and rotary islands. We'll see one by one. Divisional islands, they are intended to separate opposing flow of traffic on a highway with four or more lanes by thus dividing the highway into two one-way roads. The head-on collisions are eliminated from divisional islands. Channelizing islands, they are used to guide the traffic into proper channel through the intersection area. They are very useful as traffic control devices for intersection at grades when area is large. Pedestrian loading islands, they are provided at regular bus stop and similar places for the pedestrians' protection. So usually when we are waiting for a bus, we are required to stand. Many people are assembling there in order to get the bus to their destinations. In that case, separately for their protection, pedestrian loading islands are constructed or created. Rotary islands, it is the large central island of rotary intersection. This island is much larger than the central island of channelized intersection. Channelized intersection. You see here, this is divisional islands. It is dividing the road into two directional movements. Is it clear? This is channelized islands. It is channelizing the traffic flow from different directions. This is pedestrian island. Pedestrian can stand on this island and they can wait till the vehicles are moving on either side, and then with the help of zebra crossing, the pedestrian can cross. This is the zebra crossing. This is the zebra crossing wherein pedestrian can easily move without any problem, but they have to wait for some time, say 40 seconds, 30 seconds, till the opportunity gets, pedestrian can cross through zebra crossing. Okay. Next, Rotary Islands. Rotary Islands. Rotary intersections are roundabout. These also called as roundabout. Means, suppose the vehicle is standing here, it has to go all around the island. If he wants to go to this road, he has to travel all around the island, and then he can enter into this road. Vice versa. Suppose the vehicle is moving from this direction. Suppose the vehicle is standing here. If that vehicle wants to get into this road, then he has to go around the island and then he has to come. Means safe movement at such intersections. At grade intersections laid out for the movement of traffic in one direction around a central traffic island. Since it is provided at the center, it is also known as central traffic island. The vehicles entering the rotary are gently forced to move in a clockwise direction in orderly fashion. All vehicles will be moving in only one direction. No opposite movement, only one direction. Similarly, the same type of rotary intersections with central island is may be provided in this fashion also, with greeneries and all, in order to make it more aesthetical or beautiful view at the intersections. Vehicles are moving. Vehicle is moving all around this. Vehicles which are going toward this side, they can take the movement. The vehicles which are coming from this side, they can also take the other road movement, so that there will be safety is ensured. We will see the road marking in the next class. Okay. Thank you. Have a good day. We will stop here for today. We will continue with road marking or pavement marking in the next class. See you tomorrow.